Welcome back everyone to Indemis Student Channel. Still in our Lean Management Lecture Series, now I would like to share with you some of the Lean tools that I actually promised in our lecture in Lean Management, which focuses on the ways of Lean. So some of the tools here are already mentioned in those in that lecture. So this lecture will talk about Bokayoke, standardized work, one piece flow, and just in time. But for those of you who haven't known me, let me introduce myself. So my name is Velita Fania. This is my educational background. I learned engineering and management in production system, and I also learned industrial engineering for my bachelor study. I did some internships as well in some companies, and some of them are shown in here. Enough about me, let's just dive into the first tool directly. So the first one we want to learn about Bokayoke. Is it familiar to you the word Bokayoke is? So Bokayoke itself has various definitions, but the idea of Bokayoke is to prevent errors through product designs or other tools that might help this error prevention. For example, in the daily life, we found it also in the SIM card for your phone. Here, this little diagonal tip in here is made in order for you not to put your SIM card in a wrong direction. Another example is the USB plug. So this USB plug cannot be plugged in into the port in a wrong direction. Another way to apply this Bokayoke is not only in daily life, but you can also apply it in your assembly line. So here are the parts that you want to assemble, and also here we can see in here there is a small triangle in here. This is what we call as well as Bokayoke system. So this to prevent the employees to assemble it in a wrong direction. And therefore, the benefit that we can gain from this Bokayoke system is the decrease of defect products. The next tool would be called as standardized work. And this standardized work is referred to a system that has a standard in doing each step of the process and even in the documentation. So this can be applied everywhere, literally everywhere. In every team, in every organization. And the example of the standardized work, we can see the most common one is what we call as SOP, or Standard Operation Procedure. And this SOP is made in a very detailed manner. So this SOP is made so the worker or the person who read it can actually understand what they are going to do in the process or what they need to do in the process. So for example, this SOP can be applied in the assembly line, or it can be even applied in post office. So for example, the SOP in the post office could be starting from the waiting the package, and the next one choosing the type of the package, for example the fastest delivery time, or it could just the normal one like taking 2 or 3 days, and then inputting the name, address, and phone number of the senders and recipients, and so on. So this standardized work can prevent mistakes from the employees and also reducing the diversities in a process. The next tool is called as one piece flow. So one piece flow means the products goes one piece at a time. If we take a look here in the example, so we can see the worker in station A doing one product, and then when he finished, he send it to the station B, and if in the station B is finished, then he send it to the worker in station C, and just like that until they finish their shift. So here there will be only one product in a workstation, then it goes directly to the next workstation. So there will be no work in progress products in the system. So we can take a look here. The gain for this one piece flow is reducing the waiting time, inventory or work in progress, and overproduction. We can also reduce the bottlenecks and the delays in our system. So this, of course, can be applied not only in the production line or assembly line, but it can also apply in your organizational processes, for example. The last tool that we will discuss today is called just-in-time. This just-in-time is actually more or less similar to one-piece flow. So just-in-time is a strategy where the product or raw material is received just before it is needed. To understand it better, I make an example in here. So there are three stations in the assembly line. Let's just say in every station, they need 1 minute to finish their task. So at the beginning of the shift, the first station starts in minute zero, and the second station starts in minute one, and the last one starts in minute two. So in the third station, they need one small part from another assembly line. So this part will come to station 3 in minute 1 second 50. And this is the just-in-time system. Just before station 3 needs this part, it arrives. So there will be no inventory around this third workstations. So of course, the benefit is decreasing the inventory, and then decreasing also the waiting time and the overproduction. And that's all about the lecture today. I hope you can get an idea about what the tools are, where the tools is applied, and what's the benefit of each tool from these four tools that we already discussed. And to review this lecture, as always, I already provide a question or a case study, I would say. Then simply take your time to really read it carefully and pause the video. Okay, so now let's discuss the case. There will be two solutions that you can propose to your boss. The first one is creating the SOP in a detailed manner so that the worker can clearly see and understand how the process should be. And the second one is implementing Pokayoke to show them clearly the right direction to assemble the parts, so we can prevent errors in here and damaging the product. And here is the reference that I use to make this lecture. And that's all about this lecture. I hope you enjoy your day and already gained some information from this lecture. See you in the next one. Bye.